Game Show Network. All play, all day.
Let's all play What's My Line? And now let's meet this week's What's My Line panel. First, our own court jester. He's a jester and we caught him, Soupy Sales.
Thank you. And thank you, Chet Gould. Well, our panelist that sits to my left is really very famous. She has sung at the Metropolitan. She's also sung at Allstate and State Farm Insurance and all those other places. But no, she really is. Really, and this coming week, she's going to be singing the Elephant Song from La Tusca. Opera place down the street, and it gives me a great pleasure to welcome the very delightful, talented, lovely, gorgeous Anna Moffo.
Yeah, that's so good. Well, I teased our next wonderful young actor all week, and I've called him a masher and all kinds of things, but I've really enjoyed sitting next to him all week long in the panel. Even though he's had his hand on my knee all the time. Alan Alda.
That's right.
I thought that was my knee. Well, anyway. She's only kidding, Arlene. Arlene is my wife's name. Well, folks, here she is. She's dressed like Joan of Arc, and she's our heroine, Arlene Francis.
Thank you, dear.
That's okay.
And now, here's our knight in shining armor, Larry Blyden.
Oh, I tell you, sometimes it's just hard to get started, isn't it? One false word and everybody comes unglued. It's marvelous. Now, listen, we have a marvelous show today, and without not only much ado, but any ado, would our first challenger enter and sign in, please?
William Shakespeare.
Wilma Schneider.
Hey, Wilma.
Where are you from?
Sonoma, California.
Okay. Panel, Wilma Schneider performs a service normally performed by men. We will show the audience what her line is. And we'll start the questioning with Alan Alda.
Thank you. For some reason, I have this intuitive clap of lightning here that tells me that you do something with animals.
No.
Well,
might as well put your hands back under the table. Yeah.
He's in the Yellow Pages under David Copperfield.
Arlene?
Oh, you smell one girl who has perfume on her, and that's the end.
Yeah.
The, what you do that usually is done by men, is it done out of doors?
Sometimes.
Does it have anything whatsoever to do with a product?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Soupy.
But it is also done indoors as well as out?
Mm-hmm.
What you do when you do this, do you wear something other than what you're wearing now?
Yes.
Would it be like a coverall type?
No, not really.
Three down and seven to go, Anna.
Did we establish if you are in government position and have any government...
No, we
government
didn't.
Or, all right. Are you in any kind of governmental service?
No.
No.
Well, wait a minute, hold it. Okay, there is a governmental function involved. It is a branch of a government.
Oh, that's a yes?
Yes.
Oh, good. Now, does this branch concern in any way Did you say you did not wear overalls, but you don't wear what you're wearing? So may I assume you wear a uniform? Some
yes.
kind of, yes. Is it anything to do with the communications?
No.
Four down and six to go, Alan.
I can't keep track of the questioning. You've so thrown me off. Yeah, right. Is it...
okay, when, she wears a uniform.
Wears a uniform.
And it's involved with a branch of a government.
Yeah, right. Well, is it... are you in any form of law enforcement?
Sort of.
Sort of.
Mm-hmm.
Is it in any way... pull yourself together, Anna.
Is it
in any way related to the police department?
Sort of.
Sort of. Is it, does it have to do with that part of law enforcement which is usually after the police arrest somebody?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, that is to say with courts and justice of that kind.
Not with the courts. I tell you, we're out of time.
Oh, may I guess? Please let me guess. Please, I can't stand it. You're the person that snatches somebody who's snatching something in a store, of whatever you call a snatcher.
Floor walker.
Not a floor walker. No, no.
The house detective?
Yes.
No, she is a prison guard at San Quentin.
Ah!
I thought she did, too. And she was the first of four women to be assigned to this position. Well, why were you chosen for the job?
Probably because I worked at another institution, and I transferred to San Quentin.
Now, what is the ratio of men to women there?
It's about 350
to
five women now.
Oh.
Guards.
Guards.
Now, what are your duties there? What do you do?
Oh, I work in the gun towers, the gun rails. Right now, presently, I'm working at the East Gate.
So it's essentially the same guard work that the men do.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Now, how did they react when you first showed up there? What happened?
You mean the inmates or the other guards?
Well, first of all, let's say the guards.
Well, they were really concerned about me being there. They really didn't want me, I don't think, but they didn't know what to do with me.
Now, do you feel that you've made it?
They didn't know what to do with you?
But they were afraid that the prisoners did. How did the prisoners react?
Well, they were really surprised. I think they were sort of for me. In fact, I worked on the East Block one night, and one of the inmates fell down the stairs because he couldn't believe this woman was on his block working, you know. He fell down.
Now, do you feel that there's a special contribution that you make, or do you, in fact, make a special contribution being a woman there?
Yeah, I think so. We add sort of a softness to the place, mm-hmm. you know, sort of to boost the morale of the other correctional officers. They like to be called that, sort of guards.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, you're the most adorable correctional officer I ever saw, and thank you for coming on.
And you've seen plenty.
I see plenty.
We'll be back with more of What's My Line right after this message.
This is your host. This is your host on Match Game. Any questions? Weeknights, 6:30 Eastern, 3:30 Pacific, only on Game Show Network.
Coffee?
Sounds great. Let me just check my messages.
Hi, Mrs. Kane. It's Hill's Pharmacy. Your prescription is ready, and your total comes to $65.
Ooh, tell me that's more than one prescription.
Nope, that's how much just one of my refills costs.
So you pay regular price every time?
Our insurance doesn't cover prescriptions. What can I do?
Do what we did. Join the People's Prescription Plan.
What's that?
It's a great way to save on most prescriptions. We joined when we found out how much Medicare didn't pay. Now we get the best price available.
Yeah, but I've been on this medication for years.
It doesn't matter. You get the best price on prescriptions, old and new.
Does it cost a lot?
Are you kidding? Our membership has paid for itself many times over, and one membership covers everyone in your household.
I think I'm getting the message. Join the People's Prescription Plan.
A People's Prescription Plan membership card tells your pharmacist a lot. It says that for one low monthly fee, you and everyone in your household are guaranteed the best price the plan offers on all types of prescription drugs. New prescriptions, refills, injectables, and more. Plus, you can save up to half off the cost of eyeglasses and contact lenses. Save even more on hearing aids, vitamins, even health equipment. Just show your card at any one of thousands of pharmacies nationwide, and there are no claim forms. If you're not completely satisfied, call us within 60 days for a full refund of your membership fee. So get the lowest price available with the People's Prescription Plan. Call now.
Sue, just got back from the drugstore. I really did save with the People's Prescription Plan.
Call 1-800-322-2100 to join the People's Prescription Plan. Have your credit card ready or send check or money order to People's Prescription Plan, Valley Forge, PA, 19493. You have nothing to lose with our 60-day money-back guarantee. That number again is 1-800-322-2100. Call now.
Hey, Silver Screen Flashback puts the spotlight on you. All you have to do is play along with me, Steve Saunders, and you might win big. Monday through Friday between the classic and new Newlywed Game at 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 p.m. Pacific, only on Game Show Network.
Okay, we're back, and would our next challenger enter and sign in, please? Len Kraft.
Where are you from?
From New York City.
Okay, panel. Len Kraft is concerned with the product you see before you. We will show the audience what is unusual about it.
You can't read the label.
And we'll start the game with Anamafo.
There's something unusual about your product?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm terribly nearsighted. Am I supposed to be able to read what's...
Not necessarily.
Oh.
Hello?
Well, no, I'm fascinated by what it looks like and what I guess it isn't. your product is alcoholic?
No.
I thought
one down and nine to go, Alan.
I sense that it has something to do with the bathroom. Is that correct?
No, that's incorrect.
Animals
use it.
No. No, I thought it had something to do with the bathtub.
Oh, get your hands up on the table, Alan. Arlene?
You want to leave the room?
No, the bathtub. Darn it.
Is it something about the bottle that that is different?
Yes.
Is it either unbreakable or recycled?
No.
Three down and seven to go, Soupy.
Can we rule out that that's a, you know, one of those fake breakaway bottles that they... is?
No.
No.
Four down and six to go, Anna.
That is one of those, whatever he said.
And it's really dumb because I've been hit with so many of them things.
Len is vice president of Roscoe Labs, makers of breakaway bottles and glasses. Who uses breakaways?
Oh, they use them on television, motion picture, Broadway.
What are they made of?
It's a plastic resin that we developed the formula for.
How much are they?
They're about $4.50 for each.
Each breakaway?
Each one.
Do you make other styles other than wine bottles?
Sure. We have wine bottles and the whiskey bottles and the glasses and
sheets. Do you have any here that we can see? Any other styles?
Yes,
that we can
I
see?
Have something here, Larry.
What kind is this? This is a wine bottle.
That's a wine bottle, yeah.
That's a wine bottle. May I?
Yeah, please. Sure.
That's cute. What else do you have?
We have Coca-Cola bottles.
Coca-Cola bottles?
Yeah. Sure.
Here's break one on his head.
That looks kind of heavy. Is that, will that...
No, this wouldn't hurt, Larry.
Well, thank you for being with us on What's My Line. We'll be back with more of What's My Line right after this message.
Out here, I'm in command. So am I supposed to say, slow down, guys, I'm constipated? I don't think so. You try to eat right. Sometimes you can't. Harsh chemical laxatives, they can kick in whenever and wherever. Not an option. So I rely on doctor-recommended Metamucil. It's got 100% natural fiber. Works with my body, gently, which is important to a sensitive guy like myself.
Metamucil, the doctor's natural choice for regularity.
You don't find many kitchens like this.
Thank goodness. I can't wait to redo it.
So don't buy any appliances over $399 or electronics over $299 with your Sears card and get 0% finance charge till July 99.
So I could save on a TV for right over there?
Uh-huh.
A new stove, a new dishwasher,
and
a new fridge.
Yep.
Fabulous.
In fact, Sears even has a Kenmore refrigerator on sale for just $549.99. You save $50, so
time to get cooking.
Sure is. But hurry, sale ends Saturday.
Cancer. If you're not satisfied with your current treatment program, call this very important phone number toll-free. At Cancer Treatment Centers of America, we offer leading-edge medical technology, nutritional therapy, physical therapy, and emotional support. To find out about the innovative treatment options at our hospitals, call toll-free 1-888-381-5593. Cancer Treatment Centers of America, winning the fight against cancer every day.
Thank you, Chet. We're back, and it's time for the special feature of What's My Line? The appearance of our mystery guests. Are your blindfolds all in place, panel?
They certainly are.
Then would our mystery guest enter and sign in, please? Okay, panel, you have 3 minutes. We'll go one question at a time. Fate's law prevails, and we'll begin with Soupy Sales.
A breakaway bottle? That was a very nice ovation, mystery guest. Would we find your name in the entertainment sections of the paper?
I will get you, my dear.
Anna?
You're a girl?
What?
Yes?
Well, yeah.
Alan?
Are you a comedian?
possibly.
Arlene?
Are you appearing now in a Broadway show?
No, right now. A lot of people chasing me for it, but I'm giving them the old no. You know what I mean? You know what I mean, Al? right, baby? Yeah, no, not right now, Al.
Yeah. Two? What is that?
Does that mean that she is in a Broadway show?
No, she's
Listen,
not.
Listen, why don't you get clean your ears out with a 45 soup and you'll find out what's going on. You know what I mean? No, I am not on a Broadway show right now.
Boy, that's a great voice. Do you live mostly on the West Coast?
Listen, I live wherever they let me in, you know what I mean?
Do you live on the West Coast?
Yeah. Don't get pushy, you know, don't get pushy.
Ella?
It can't be true. Are you Eileen Farrell?
There's a Satan similarity.
There is?
Yeah, so now, Anna, you're out. So you're going to have to cool it now. You can take your mask off if you want to until we get now it's Alan's time.
All right.
Yeah, go to Alan, baby. Yeah. You're a real charm boy.
Yeah. Have you ever played Liza in My Fair Lady?
No, it was Henry Doolittle, as a matter of fact.
Eileen?
Now, wait a minute. You have something in common with Eileen Farrell. Is it the shape you're in?
If you'd like to rephrase it, I might give you an answer.
Soupy?
Are you ever on... have we ever worked together?
Oh, honey, you know it.
Oh. I'd like to take a guess.
All right.
Is it Rosemary?
I don't know.
Okay, you can take your mask off now, Alan.
I think I know who it is, but I can't... My mind is blank on the name, but I can picture you. Can I take off my mask and tell you if I'm right?
Isn't it funny? Honey, I always called you Alan Seuss.
No, I'll be honest about it. Can I?
No.
I can't, no. All right. Are you a large person? Are you
well, let's see, I ain't... Yeah, I'm a lot bigger than a bread box.
Okay. Arlene?
Do you sing?
Well, with this voice, would you sing?
Okay. I must say, with that answer, we ran out of time. Take off your mask, Alan. Arlene, this is Pat Carroll. That was really good.
You know, actually, I had to do this because my voice is kind of hoarse now, and I just played it because I've been rehearsing Anything Goes, and Mr. Porter writes those tunes that go from here way up to there. And so I'm a little a noddy right now.
Now, where are you going to do it?
Well, I'm working dinner theaters for the first time. They're quite intriguing.
You know, they're marvelous.
Fascinating. I think it's a growing thing in this country because it's such a good buy for your entertainment dollar, and it's such good family entertainment. You know, I think
is it all included in the price of the ticket?
Yes, you pay the one price, and you get your dinner, and you get the entire show, and of course your little tiddly-poos, whatever you drink, are extra.
Yeah,
but it's a marvelous way of entertaining, and usually all the shows that are done are for the entire family, so you can take the kids, and if Grandma doesn't drink too much, she can go too. You know, so
they're great. Wonderful, appreciative audiences, and they're really great
very
fun.
Exciting.
Good luck with it, and thank you for being with us.
All
what's my life. Thanks. Come back. We'll be back with more of What's My Line in just a moment.
Tonight, you have two chances to play Inquisition from Home, if you dare. First at 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific, then a new game at 9:30 Eastern, 6:30 Pacific. Live. Interactive. All you need is a touch-tone phone and nerves of steel. Inquisition only on Game Show Network.
Which after-shower spray cleaner leaves no dull residue? The answer is as clear as the label on the bottle. New Shower Shine from the Scrubbing Bubbles. They work hard after every shower, so you don't have to. If you're not using New Shower Shine after-shower spray cleaner, the forecast for your shower is mostly cloudy. New Shower Shine from the Scrubbing Bubbles. They work hard after every shower, so you don't have to.
Pampers Premium is changing the way it looks. But don't worry, we're still as good as gold. Just look for the gold heart and ribbon on our new premium package.
The Arm & Hammer Challenge. How's your cat litter work?
The odor clumps break apart.
And the smell is left behind.
Let's compare it to Super Scoop.
With our brand, the odor clumps are breaking up.
The Arm & Hammer odor clumps all in one piece. It's amazing.
It would cut down on the smell.
Try the super way to scoop odor away.
Paying bills has been difficult since my husband got hurt. Bill collectors called day and night. We thought of bankruptcy. But then a friend told us about Garden State.
Garden State is a nonprofit agency that works with your creditors to make an affordable payment plan for all your bills.
After speaking with our counselor, we save thousands of dollars in interest. Thank you, Garden State.
Get your bills together and call now for your free consultation. We can help you get out of debt. Call 1-800-99-BILLS.
98 plus $4.95 shipping. Call now.
Next up, you can fill in the blank with Match Game, followed by celebrities airing their secrets on Tattletales and extreme entertainment on Extreme Gong.
Okay, would our next challenger enter and sign in, please? Priscilla Lochner. That's a pretty outfit you have on there.
Thank you.
Where are
you
from?
Neptune, New Jersey.
Okay, panel. Priscilla Lochner is in the insurance business, and we'll show the audience what her company insures against. And let's start with Alan Alda.
Thank you. Is this something that the company insures against? Is it something other than a physical loss?
Yes.
Other than a physical loss?
Yes.
Okay. Is it...
You mean a personal physical loss?
I mean like the loss,
loss
of a house.
Ah, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Something that's physical properties. Is it something interpersonal?
Yes.
Well, wait a minute. Hold it one second.
Between people.
No, when you say physical.
Well, I mean like the destruction of an object would be a physical loss.
So you're guessing this is a loss between people?
Yeah.
One down and nine to go, Arlene.
Oh, it's not a loss between people. Is it a loss between animals?
No. Mm-hmm.
Two down, eight to go, Soupy.
And you insure people for this?
Yes.
People take out insurance against this.
Like, for example, like getting struck by lightning in a submarine.
Yeah,
something like that. While you're riding a camel. And eating a donut. You know.
Is that it?
I told you, that's it. Oh, no, all right. Is it about the loss of something like would be like your voice or something like that?
No.
Three down, seven to go. Anna.
I'm not clear on what it is. I mean, from what you said before, I would say from the loss of your voice would fit in that category.
But it's not specific.
But it's not a physical thing.
It's not. I see. Uh-huh. But it is against. Can I presume that whatever you're insuring, the premiums are very high?
No.
No.
Four down and six to go, Alan.
Kind of narrowed down the field here. It's not. It doesn't involve objects, and it doesn't involve other people or relationships.
Right.
So what can happen to a person that, if he, let's say, I take it you don't insure against the loss of your soul?
That's right.
Right. We wouldn't do business in New Jersey like that.
No.
And she'd never insure Ray Charles.
Except in the local government, or state government.
And not on election year.
Yeah, right. Well, is it... let's see. Let me deal another way. Do you insure both men and women for this?
Yes.
Is it something not related to people's businesses necessarily?
Boy.
I mean,
not related to their business.
Could a so-called housewife take out this insurance as well as a businessman?
Yes.
Okay. It's not related to animals. We said that. Not related to the object. There's very little left. Is it related to ha-ha?
Yes, of course.
Is it
related? It's directly related to ha-ha.
Is it related in any way to the to weather?
Yes.
Is it related to vacations and weather on vacations?
Yes.
Yes.
Well, what do you want? Rain.
All right, you got it. Yay, Alan, that's terrific. That's really good. Mrs. Lochner works for Frank J. Siracusa and Son. How does your program work?
Well, we have two programs. When you come to the shore area from Asbury Park to Cape May, we have a rain insurance program whereby if it rains 1/10 of an inch between 10 o'clock in the morning and 4 in the afternoon, for 75 cents a day, you can insure your vacation for $25. Now, this is with one-day deductible. Now, in other words, if it rains for 3 days, you're paid for two. Now, under the other program, there is one. If 1/4 of an inch of rain falls between 10 and 4 in the afternoon, you are for $2 a day, you are paid $25, and that is with no days deductible.
Can I ask you a question? Does that mean if a honeymoon couple goes down there and it rains?
Who cares?
You pay them to stay in their hotel room, is that it?
Exactly.
It's not bad.
Go down and pray for rain. Goodbye, everybody. We'll see you around. Have fun.
This program was recorded.
Game Show Network. All play, all day.